Hello friends, welcome to my channel Learning Electronics. In the last class we have studied mapping theorem, which is also called as principle of argument. So if you want to see that video, you can check it in the channel playlist. So in this lecture number 5 of Nyquist plot, we are going to study Nyquist stability criterion. So before starting the video, please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon so that you can get more updated videos from here. Now let us discuss some important points related to Nyquist criterion. Nyquist is a scientist who has developed a criterion to study the stability of the control system in the frequency domain. Nyquist also suggested to select a single valued function which is represented by f of s as 1 plus g of s into h of s. Now according to this statement, f of s will be equal to 1 plus g of s into h of s. The configuration which we have studied in the previous classes, which is developed by Nyquist, is the poles of 1 plus g of s into h of s. This 1 plus g of s into h of s is called as characteristic equation. So poles of this characteristic equation will be equal to poles of g of s into h of s, which is equal to open loop poles of the system. The zeros of this characteristic equation 1 plus g of s into h of s will be equal to closed loop poles of the system. So this is the configuration which is developed by Nyquist. Then for stability, all the zeros of this characteristic equation 1 plus g of s into h of s should lie in the left half of the s plane. None of the zeros should lie in the right half of the s plane. This we already studied in the previous classes. Nyquist suggested that instead of finding whether all the zeros are in the left half of the s plane, it is better to examine any one zero in right half of the s plane, which is making the system unstable. Now, according to the Nyquist, the active region of stability becomes right half of the S plane. Nyquist also suggested to select the path tau of S which will encircle the entire right half of S plane instead of choosing any arbitrary path. This path which is to be selected, which encircles the entire right half of the S plane, should start from S is equal to plus infinity and continue till S is equal to minus infinity. This S is equal to plus infinity will be the start point, and this S is equal to minus infinity will be the end point. And this is along the imaginary axis and completed with a semicircle of infinite radius encircling entire right half of the S plane. So this path is called as Nyquist path, which is shown in this figure. So here we can see that there is a semicircle of radius infinity, and this semicircle on the imaginary axis range is from plus j infinity to minus j infinity. So this semicircle represents the Nyquist path. This we have already studied in the last class when we have studied the mapping theorem, that n is equal to number of encirclements of origin of f plane by Nyquist plot. Then as per the mapping theorem we have studied in the last class, the number of encirclements of origin of f plane by Nyquist plot will be equal to z minus p. Here z is equal to number of zeros of 1 plus g of s into h of s encircled by Nyquist path in s plane. As we have seen in the previous diagram, that Nyquist path encircles the right half of the s plane. Therefore, the z should be taken equal to number of zeros of 1 plus g of s into h of s, which are located in the right half of the S plane, and P will be equal to number of poles of 1 plus G of S into H of S, which are located on the right half of the S plane. But for absolute stability of the system, no zero of 1 plus G of S into H of S must lie on the right half of the S plane. That means the number of zeros which are lying in the right half of the S plane should be equal to 0 for absolute stability. So Nyquist criteria is obtained by substituting z is equal to 0 in this equation of n is equal to z minus p. When we put z is equal to 0 in this equation, we will get n is equal to minus p. So this is the condition we should be satisfied under the Nyquist criteria. Now we will see the statement of Nyquist stability criteria. Nyquist stability criteria states that for absolute stability of the system, the number of encirclements of new origin of F plane by Nyquist plot must be equal to the number of poles of 1 plus G of S into H of S, that is poles of 1 plus G of S into H of S, which are in right half of the S plane and in the clockwise direction. So according to this statement, the number of encirclements of the origin of F plane should be equal to the minus of number of poles of the 1 plus G of S into H of S, which are in the right half of the S plane in the clockwise direction. This negative sign indicates the direction of the path in the clockwise direction. Now to understand this, let us take one example. We have taken the open loop transfer function G of S into H of S equal to 10 divided by S into S plus 1. Here we can see that no zeros are present from the numerator of this function, and from the denominator of this function we can see that two poles we have, that is at S is equal to 0 and at S is equal to minus 1. When we represent these poles on the S plane, we can see that all these poles which are given in this function, that is S is equal to 0 and S is equal to minus 1, are not lying in the right half of the S plane, since P is equal to number of poles of 1 plus G of S into H of S, which are located on the right half of the S plane. Here we can take the number of poles which are lying in the right half of S plane is equal to 0. Okay, since the poles of this function are not lying in the right half of the S plane. Therefore, we know that for absolute stability, this condition should be satisfied, that is N is equal to minus P. So when we put the value of P here, we will get N is equal to 0. That means the Nyquist plot obtained by mapping Nyquist path from S plane to F plane should not encircle the origin of F plane. When N is equal to 0 is coming, that means the Nyquist path is not encircling the origin of F plane. But for ease of mapping, what we do? We consider G of S into H of S instead of 1 plus G of S into H of S. In this case, the stability criteria remains the same, that is N is equal to minus P. But here P will be equal to number of poles of G of S into H of S, which are located in the right half of the S plane. And N will be equal to number of encirclements of critical point minus 1 plus J0 of F plane by the Nyquist plot. So here one change is there. Instead of taking this N equal to number of encirclement of the new origin of F plane, we are taking N is equal to number of encirclements of the critical point minus 1 plus J0 of F plane by Nyquist plot, because we have changed the function to be equal to G of S into H of S. So our N is also changing here. So hope you have understood this topic. Thank you very much for watching, and please do subscribe my channel for more updates.